I'm Aaron Liao. I run evangelism here at DocuSign. I'm with Dewey Wall today in our Seattle office. It's a frosty winter Seattle day, but we're here to show you some cool stuff that you can do using the API. Specifically, some of the things that you can't necessarily or easily do using our web interface. So Dewey, why don't you talk us through the scenario that we're going to show today?
Well, today I'm going to focus mainly on what we call document visibility at DocuSign. And what that is the ability to, for a sender or an account to send out a document that can be split up on who can see what.
Okay.
In our scenario that we're going to show is an HR type flow where we're sending out an offer letter to a person that's going to go through some approval steps that we don't really necessarily want the person that's going to be signing the offer to see.
Cool.
And we want to do this all in one package, so we're going to use what we call document visibility for that.
Okay, awesome. So the idea is that, hey, maybe a job offer needs to be approved by multiple people at a company first before it can be sent to the recipient, and the recipient, obviously we don't want them to see that, you know, accounting had to okay this, and finance, and maybe a VP had to okay it, things like that, right?
That's correct.
Perfect. That's correct. Sounds good.
The angle I'm going to take today is showing you how you get this done through the API, as you mentioned earlier.
Wonderful.
So we will show some of the technical details on how that's done.
Sounds good. Let's do it.
All right. So the first thing we're going to do is when you set up your API request, and we're going to be doing our REST API approach,
okay,
using JSON, you have to configure all of your recipients that you want in the envelope, which I've done here. And for each recipient, it's as simple as specifying which of the documents they cannot see.
Okay.
So you exclude documents for that recipient if you do not want them to see them. Some of the tricks to this is you cannot specify a signing type tab or a form field to be filled out by that signer.
Okay.
Or they will have to see that document.
Okay. Got it.
So as you see here, I've got in my position one, we're going to have our managers go ahead and send out or sign first. They're the ones that are going to send the offer letter to the candidate.
Okay.
And you'll see in that case, I'm not excluding any documents. And in our current workflow, we're going to have two documents. One is an approval document and one being the offer letter.
Okay.
After they're going to be at routing order one, the second person in our workflow, as we scroll down here, you'll see is the approver. And that person will be at routing order two, and again, we're not going to exclude any documents because they're going to need to see the offer letter as well as approve it. And so a little side feature that we're showing in this flow is the approval process DocuSign has in place where we can put an approve and a decline button on for that person, which immediately moves the envelope onto the next route or actually stops the envelope in its tracks.
Okay, cool.
Without putting a mark on the document.
Sure.
So that's just a side thing we'll get to see during this process. And the last signer we're going to have is actually the candidate for the
recipient job of the offer.
Yeah,
yep,
the person that's going to sign the job offer. And that's that person will be in route three and be last. And you'll see the trick to it is we have an array of documents in here that we're excluding that you add on the recipient node of the request. So part of the recipient JSON is which documents you don't want to include. And all you do is put the IDs of the documents into an array of the request. So it's pretty straightforward and simple. And the last thing you'll show here is that we have the two documents, one is being our offer letter and the one being our approval approval checklist that
okay.
goes in the envelope. So I'm going to go ahead and send this out now using Postman. I already have it queued up in here. And when I send it, we'll actually go over to the inboxes of these various recipients and take a look at what
awesome.
They see when they get that document or that set of documents. So I'm using mail and emails for demonstration purposes in the DocuSign demo environment. So the first person that we are going to check is the one that was first in the route because they were the only ones that can access the envelope at this time. We'll go ahead and launch their inbox, and we'll see that we have the request here in there for them, and we're going to take a look at that. As you see, when we pull up the documents, you'll see that this signer, which is the manager, can see both documents in our workflow, and they're going to have to do some, as I scroll down here, you'll see that there's our document, that's our letter to our candidate, the first two pages, And I'm gonna go ahead and sign that as the manager saying I'm gonna go ahead and send this offer out. And secondly, you'll see there's the checklist that is gonna go through the approval process of our HR department. So I'm gonna go ahead and just say that I've verified this job opening and I did a background check on this person. And I'm gonna go ahead and finish my role in this process. And now as we go back to the next signer, which is going to be our HR person, we will see that in our inbox of the HR person, we will see that we have a document to review. And this is where you will see the addition of the approve and the decline tabs that are part of a feature that DocuSign has. And again, you'll see that both documents are in here. And as the job manager, I'm gonna go ahead and verify that this manager's went through all the right steps and just approve this. And what this does automatically completes that envelope and routes it on to the next recipient.
Okay.
So the next recipient then, which is actually the person we're going to hire, will see the same document or the same envelope as the first two did. But here's the trick to it with the document visibility. As I open the envelope, you'll see that the no longer can you see that second document, which is the checklist that the internal candidates got to, or the internal employees got to see, but the candidate does not.
Oh, slick, okay.
And so there you'll see that there's only one document remaining in this envelope.
Which is the offer itself.
Which is the offer itself, and that's all they get to see. They don't get to see all those steps that the other ones,
very cool,
the other people in the workflow had to go through. So then that's really the end of the workflow. If we sign now, we are done, and that offer is accepted. Now, as the sender of this document, if you pull this up, you will see both documents and everybody in the workflow in that,
okay,
in that stat or in that finalized envelope. So that is it for document visibility and how it works.
Very cool.
As you can see, it's actually quite simple to do in our API, and the how you set it up in the API is really simple. As you just exclude the documents by ID, which ones you do not want to show for that particular person.
Very handy. So,